Hello, 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 and welcome to What Would You Do If I Was Naked Right Now? Anyway, we're playing RTA today in the game called Epic 7. It is the seventh installment in the Epic series. You may have heard of it from Epic 1 through 6, but those were kind of niche, like cult classic style games. Anyway, I picked some units and I had a game with them. So let's just jump right into it. I am facing Biako 11, whose name is pretty familiar to me. I always forget to do that when I'm doing the it's just a quality of life thing that I'm so upset I keep missing. It's a highlight glance. It's the Arwell, the cat girl with a cat shield and cat hood. Because she went to Japan once and got really into the culture of cat cafes. So she decided that cosplaying was probably the best way to get her point across. She also doesn't like wearing pants, which is interesting. It's not pants. She's wearing, like, a leotard with, thigh-high boots? I guess those are boots. Nice dual attack, by the way. It is not an effect res, Arwell, or if it is an effect res Arwell, it doesn't have as much as I thought it would. I just do a polite little laugh for the dual attack, just because it's funny to me when 3% chances happen, like, almost constantly. For me or against me, it doesn't really matter. It's just funny. But yeah, I recognize this guy's name. He's a pretty good player. He's in the Baka 7 guild, which is a pretty well-known guild, I think. I don't know. I actually don't know anything about this game in terms of, like, the meta-narrative, I guess, is what you'd want to call it. I don't know. The guilds and the people in the guilds and stuff like that. I don't know. I just hit the funny buttons and... I just hit the buttons and the characters are cute and this is funny to me. Landy, giving up all abandon, reckless abandon, one would say, and just deciding to let loose the S3 since Charlotte already had a buff, so she would kind of be doing her thing anyway. They're going to push up the Arwell, S3, the DJB, to get rid of the shield inversion person. I lied, they're going for the Charlotte. I forgot, I don't know why they didn't go for the DJB. They stun the Charlotte, sure, but I get to eat their barriers, which is pretty delicious, pretty yum yum. They can kill DJB anytime and that the barrier inversion isn't too big of an issue. Cause Landy can just hopefully kill her here. But it did allow me to get blinds on everybody. I think they went after DJB and missed. They don't have anyone to revive. So DJB's going down here. That's fine for me. They can go for the full team cleanse on... but they're not going to. Which works for me. They're trying to prevent hitting my Charlotte as much as humanly possible. But my Yoha is getting dangerously close to feeding time. And by feeding time, I mean she's hungry. She's a hungry girl. You see, she's been injured a little bit and Frenzy tends to take her gold. But she is a almost 32k chonky lad. We don't know. She could be a boy. They're spirits. Their genders are all mixed up and muddled. And who knows? She could be all and both and none at the same time. We'll never know. But she's pretty and crazy, and that's what I like, so it doesn't matter. Anyway, here we go. The Destina, is she going to just push up the Arwell? Nope, she's just going to push herself up, which is fine. I don't particularly care about that. I presume she's doing that so that she can kind of get a little bit of an advantage next turn, since my Charlotte is... Boy, she is slow. To say the least, I'm just gonna kill off the Arwell, push back the Aravi, and then do my best to control. I get the lucky dual attack this time, which is very nice. It is with the Stene. But to be fair, their DPS brought their DPS, so It's an equivalent exchange type deal. I'm fine with it. This entire fight is just leading up to one thing, by the way, just because, like, the only reason I wanted to kind of upload this, I guess, it doesn't matter. I have another soul burn. I'm going to kill the Landy. I'm going to kill the Arwell. My Charlotte has taken so many turns without any sort of buff on her. But she's just waiting. She's just waiting. I'm going to get the attack down. And it doesn't really matter. I probably should have gone into the Destina. I was trying to push the Aravi ahead of the Destina. But I didn't quite get lucky. So she's going to be able to S3 into... Nope, she's going to S1 into Yoha. Kill her. But now... You gotta have to hit Charlotte. And I'm not really afraid of their Landy anymore. Because she doesn't have full burst when she died. So she'll come... If she comes back, she won't have full burst. I just barely don't kill the Aravi. Go for the S3. Not enough to kill it. And since we're in Frenzy 6, this will absolutely be able to kill the Charlotte. But guess what?
Surprise, motherfucker. I got holy sack.
Anyway, they get to stun her and probably kill her. But I do not care. Because that is all the buffer I needed to be able to kill the Aravi with a last Steny S3 and kill the Arwell in as well. Thanks to the escort buff. So, Charlotte did nothing except for a surprise. The greatest surprise that you could give someone. You can't actually hit my Stene this turn, sorry. Which is just, ooh boy, you hate to see it. But it was a really good match, Biako. I am sorry, not sorry for the Holy Sack, Charlotte. That tech only works once for each player, so now they know that my Charlotte is Holy Sack. So thank you for the game. It was very, very fun. If you liked this video, give it a like, give it a subscribe, share it with your dog, share it with your friends, share it with your trees. I'm sure they might be ants. They might enjoy entertainment. You don't know. I mean, plants are alive after all, and all you vegetarians are just killing them ruthlessly and slaughtering their family by the dozen. And eating the Brussels sprouts, the delicious, delicious broccoli and Brussels sprouts, which, did you know, come from the same plant, I think. I think it's broccoli, cauliflower, kohlrabi, Brussels sprouts, asparagus, and kale all come from the same plant. Look it up. It's all just different parts of the plant at different stages in that plant's life cycle. It's actually very interesting and very delicious, too. Also, throw them in the oven. Don't ever boil vegetables, ever. I will come to your house and slap you. Throw them in the oven. You get the Maillard reaction. It's delicious. It's delicious! Oh, I didn't hit the end record button. I hit the leave button. Well, this is awkward. Goodbye.